Attorney General Eric Holder announced today that he is going to quit right before November's elections, and I think Americans were shocked that there are elections in November. But, you know, the Attorney General, it's a special kind of job. You know, every because it's the top cop. It's the Justice Department. Everybody wants their homie there. JFK had his brother. Nixon and Reagan had their personal lawyers. And Obama said, you know what, I can't put a lot of black guys in this administration or they'll go fucking nuts, but this is the one place I want a black guy. And I feel like besides being America's top cop, he was also America's bad cop to Obama's good cop, because he could say the things Obama couldn't quite say. Here's a quote from Eric Holder, why he's such a badass. He said, though this nation has proudly thought of itself as an ethnic melting pot, in things racial we have always been, and continue to be in many ways, essentially a nation of cowards. I wonder how that went over on Fox News. Is that true?
Listen.
I must be the black guy.
Listen.
I'll agree with the black guy.
I think that's inartful, actually. But I do believe that we don't necessarily fess up to the racial realities in this country, and that we don't deal with the systemic issues of racism. We've dealt with the codified racial issue in the 60s. We have not dealt with systemic issues that we have today. And now we're slowly drifting back into a system where people are again being disenfranchised, where mass incarceration is a huge problem that disproportionately affects black and brown people in this country. And until we acknowledge that there are people in this country who have who get privileges from not having to deal with that, and people who are oppressed by that, then we are not necessarily having a legitimate conversation.
Let me add something else to that. I think there's an uneven education opportunity here. I think in many of the areas where black and brown people live, in our inner cities, in the more depressed places, the quality of education is not the same that we find in suburban America. And we should be all about equality in education. That might help the problems in the prison system and elsewhere.